We are under the lights as the show gets you ready for another edition of Major League Baseball. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the Houston Astros and the Oakland A's. Here's Michael Brantley, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. This one's flared out toward left. Here comes Davis. He can't get there as it falls in.
Batting second, the third baseman, number two.
Stepping in now, Alex Bregman. 3-1 now as that misses down and in. Swung on and missed, 3-2.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
And that's outside. He lost him ball four.
That is third.
Brantley over at second. Bregman at first with no outs. Fastball called strike, 1-2. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
Number three hole hitter up right now. Cleanup guy on deck. Two ball, two strike count. I think pitcher wants to make something happen right here.
And that's through into left, a base hit. The throw home. And not in time as he just crosses the plate in time. So now to the plate, Yordan Alvarez. Swung on but fouled off to the left. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. Now at the plate, Carlos Correa. And Houston looking for more here in just the opening frame of the game. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two.
Yeah, I get it. They want to run this guy's pitch count up, but that was a pretty good pitch to hit. He might be kicking himself that he didn't swing at that one.
The second for one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. And that'll bring in Ramon Laureano. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Down low, two balls and a strike. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
And a diving effort, but he can't make the play in right. Around second now, and this ball still hasn't been fielded. And he'll get there as he starts the home first with a leadoff triple. At the plate, Tony Kemp. And he's able to lay off there for ball four. And that'll put runners at the corners now with still nobody out. So digging in now, Marcus Semien, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. All even now, 2-2. This is hit sharply to the left side. A leap, but he can't bring it down. Base hit. And the tying run is in to score from third. It's 1-1.
Batting fourth, the first baseman.
To the plate now, Matt Olson. 2-1 to the A's first baseman.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. In the air, out to right. Reddick has a read on it. One down. Plate, Mark Canna, and Oakland with an opportunity for more damage here in the first.
Canna.
1-1 pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two.
Hey, you know the pitcher right now, he's looking for that best friend, that double play ball. This is where you have to really be disciplined at the plate and make sure that you get a pitch that's above the knees that you can get in the air.
And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. So it's first and second with two men gone. And up next, the power-hitting third baseman, Matt Chapman. Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike.
Well, he's in a bit of hot water in this first inning, but if he can start throwing his slider effectively like that, he has a lot better chance of settling into this game.
Fouled away. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Stepping into the box, George Springer. He'll get us started in the top of the second. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now.
He walked a guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
Davis
will get there as he makes the catch in foul territory for the first down. So the base is empty here with one away, and that brings up the former Gold Glover Josh Reddick. A 1-1. This is hit the other way out toward left field.
Davis
will get there with ease as he puts it away for out number two. So bases are empty here with two gone. And digging into bat next, the Cuban import Yuli Gurriel. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Hey, pretty aggressive pitch right there up in the zone. Surprised he didn't offer at it.
A bouncer to the left side. Oh, beautiful dive in time. Here's Chris Davis now. He was hitless in yesterday's shutout loss, as were many of his teammates. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch.
Now the 3-2.
And it's fouled away. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. In now, Stephen Piscotty on a good pitch there. Had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
And I really don't know how you swing at that. He must have had his mind up he was going to swing as soon as the ball came out of the pitcher's hand.
Three balls and two strikes for Stephen Piscotty.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Looking up is Brantley into the concrete staircases and gone.
Oh, that swing has to feel good right there. If you look at the numbers, this guy does not give up many long balls. To take him deep in this spot certainly is huge.
Standing in now, Austin Allen. And he fouls this one off. No outs, nobody on. And he struck him out. Back to the top of the order now. And up next will be Ramon Laureano. The 1-1 home. Hard hit ball to second. There is Altuve. Throw on to first, two gone. Now to the plate, Tony Kemp. He drew a base on balls his first time up. The 1-1 home. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Ooh-wee. That was some smoke right there. High fire right on by.
Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Now batting, Martin Maldonado, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's...
He's able to take the ball the other way here. High and deep to right center. Now this will rattle up against the wall. Meanwhile, this ball is into right center, and that ought to be good enough for extra bases. And he is into second base with a leadoff double. At the plate now, Michael Brantley. Just got the corner that time with a fastball, strike two. On the ground to the right side. He'll get to this one deep in the hole. And that's out number one. Stepping in, Alex Bregman. He drew a walk his first time up. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Everyone in the ballpark knows what the pitcher's intentions are in this situation. Great job at the plate to lay off a tough pitch in a good spot.
Reined in, and he'll step on first himself for the out. So a man at third here with two gone, and that'll bring in Jose Altuve.
Jose Altuve.
1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Third inning here. 3-1 our score. In the dirt and block behind the plate, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. All even at 2-2, here it is. But pulled in at the hot corner, and that ends the inning. Bottom of the third now, stepping into the box, Marcus Semien, looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at bat.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Fouled off. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. 0-for-1 here in the early going. Snatched out of midair at first base for out number two. The plate now is the designated hitter, Mark Canna. He got called out on strikes his last time through. The 1-1. Two out, nobody on. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. A bouncer up the middle. Altuve fields it cleanly. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. All set for the start of the fourth. Next will be the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Lifted in the air out to right. Piscotty's there for it. And that's the second out of the inning. So coming to the plate, George Springer. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far.
A Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
And a full count to George Springer. It's 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
The right fielder, Josh Reddick.
Fouled away. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. It's a two balls and two strikes now. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
But he will close fast out there in right field as he comes on to put it away, and the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. So stepping in, Matt Chapman. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Got him on the good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. Chris Davis next to bat. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. In for strike two.
It's been more than two innings since this guy's allowed anyone to reach base. He looks pretty unbeatable on the bump right now.
Two balls and two strikes, the count to Chris Davis. 2-2. 3-1 is our score here in inning number four. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. A shot down the first baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Hit in the air down the right field line. On the move is Reddick, and no one will track it down. Another payoff pitch. Drilled down the line, but foul.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
He loses him on ball four.
Up next for Oakland, the right fielder, Stephen.
Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Working for the punch out and the offering. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Now batter.
Stepping in, Austin Allen comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Line drive to left. Brantley is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Ready to go in the top of the fifth. Now in the box, Yuli Gurriel. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And up next, the former Angel Martin Maldonado. The 1-1 home is looked at for ball number two.
Hey, after the double in his first at bat, looks like he's trying to pitch around this guy a little bit.
Fastball just missed above the zone.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
Hit hard up the middle, and that is through into center field for a one-out single. into the box, Michael Brantley. Three balls and a strike to Houston's left fielder. And he lays off here. A nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away. And that'll bring up Alex Bregman. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. The 1-1 home. Grounded back up the middle. One there. Relay to Olsen. They turn the double play, and that retires the side. So the Oakland lineup turns over, and to the plate, Ramon Laureano. He tripled earlier, making him 1-for-2 in the ballgame. 3-2 to the A's center fielder.
From 0-2 to 3-2, what a great at-bat to start this inning off. Hey, this could be a productive inning.
And he struck him out, and that's 8 strikeouts thus far. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Swing, and he popped him up over in foul territory back behind third. Bregman is over, and he tucks it away for the second out.
Not short stop.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And up next, a Berkeley area native, Marcus Semien. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And foul, though it had the home run distance. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Oh, don't know how you lay off that one, but he did, and it's 2-2. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full. 3-2. Matt Olson would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And the inning will continue as that's through for a 2-out hit.
Now batting, the first baseman.
Stepping in now, Matt Olson. Below the zone, a swing and a miss. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Digging in to try it again, Jose Altuve. He's set to lead us off in the 6th inning. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball 4, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the 6th. Ready for another chance? Yordan Alvarez, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. Throw over to first. There goes Altuve. In the dirt here. Pitches in the dirt and knocked down, and he'll make it into second easily with a stolen base. Now the 2-1. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
And that's the first out. So next to swing the bat will be Carlos Correa. No hits in 2 trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. The 3-1. And that misses ball 4. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning. We're in the 6th inning here in a 3-1 ballgame. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. That's down into left center for a base hit. J.B. Wendelken is given the ball here to try to work out of a tough situation. Two runners in scoring position to deal with.
Now pitching for the A's, number 57.
Into the box now, Josh Reddick. Reddick behind the ball and 2 strikes. Lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. Ready now. Two-strike pitch on its way. Well hit. Deep down the right field line. And it's a foul ball. Hits are even right now at 5 aside. And he struck him out. And wouldn't this be something if he could work out of this with that one-run lead still in check?
So here's Yuli Gurriel.
And it appears they're going to give him the intentional walk here, so now they'll have a force at any base with two gone. Ready once again, Martin Maldonado, one of the bigger spots in the ballgame so far. Base is juiced now with two away. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hey, that's the kind of swing you'd like to see a guy take with the bases loaded. He's going for the downs.
And it's fouled away. Payoff pitch on its way. And another foul ball. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. So now it's Mark Canna. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. And he pulled up in time, but it's a called strike two.
Look at the radar gun on that slider. Off speed pitch, 91 miles an hour. That's just pure filth.
And he struck him out. So double digits now. 10 strikeouts for him thus far. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field, and it's gone as they add still another.
Yeah, everyone in the stadium, including the guy in the mound, knew it was just a matter of time until this guy cranked one out of here. Well, that's the first one of the year, and many more are sure to follow.
Ryan Abreu
will come on in relief as he'll make his second appearance of the season so far.
Abreu.
At the plate, Chris Davis. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Well hit to right, but that's a foul ball. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away. Outfielder Stephen Piscotty the next to hit. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And he fouls this one off. Four runs, six hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the A's so far. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. Lou Trevino will come on in relief as he'll make his second appearance of the season so far. Into the box, Michael Brantley. It was a walk in his last trip.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
Swing and oh my, hit him with the hein! Gone to lead off the inning.
There's an old saying in the game, they say solo homers won't kill you. This might be a good time for a mound visit right here. Try and erase those negative thoughts and get right back in the zone. You still have the lead.
To the plate now, Alex Bregman. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. ready with the 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. Base is empty here with nobody out. And again, he's unable to keep it fair, but he's putting together quite a battle at the plate. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
High chopper to third. Chapman brings it in. On to first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out. Ready for another shot now. Jose Altuve, a hit in two tries so far. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Wisely lays off the cut fastball there. It's 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
And a cut fastball, but this bounces near the plate for a ball. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential time run here is aboard late in the game. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Yordan Alvarez. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. And the count will be full.
It's going to be back to some serious teamwork if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Three runs, six hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. And he missed with it. Ball four. So that means now the potential tying run will move into scoring position at second. Yusmer Petit comes on to pitch here with one man gone in the top of the seventh. Carlos Correa will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Fouled off. Here's the 1-2 delivery.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there, really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
Hit hard on the ground at first. To second for one. On to first, and talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. Framber Valdez will come on in relief as he'll make his second appearance of the season so far. Bottom of the inning now. Into the box now. Austin Allen, 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Hard hit towards center. And there's a base hit, so a chance for some insurance here to start out the home half of the seventh.
The bat, number 22.
At the plate now, Ramon Laureano. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Brantley is under it, one away. The throw is wild, and it gets away. Stepping in now, the speedy Tony Kemp. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Here's the 1-1. And he misses, 2-1. We're in the seventh inning now of a 4-3 ball game. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. The second for one, but one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue. Next up for the A's, Marcus Semien. It was a single for him in his last at bat. And a great location that time on the corner, 3-2 now.
One of my favorite pitches in the game right there, the old Greg Maddux equalizer.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. Definitely had the distance, but it winds up a foul ball. foul, and it looks like that's going to make it into the VIP seats. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. The set and the 1-1. A ball and two strikes now.
A good fastball that backed him off the plate. And then some slow stuff down and away. That's one of the classic ways to mess up a hitter's timing. Up and in, down and away, textbook.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Joaquin Soria has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 48.
Ball set for the start of the inning. Digging in once again, George Springer. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. The 1-2.
If you're on the mound right there and you're getting a swing at a breaking ball off the plate, do not be shocked if he's tucked something up under this guy's chin hot right here.
Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. So a full count now.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game. Time called here, as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. So here's Josh Reddick. Lifetime numbers against Soria. He brings a 4-for-12 line. He also has one home run. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Curveball bounces, and this one gets away. And not what they were hoping for, as that moves the possible tying run into scoring position. Here now the 2-2. Fouled away. 4-3 our score here as we play the eighth. Count remains 2-2.
Four foul balls in this AB. Pitcher cannot find anywhere to go to put this guy away.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat. Lifted in the air to center field. Laureano will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number two. So striding in, Martin Maldonado, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Ready with the payoff pitch. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. Chris Devinsky is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 47. Chris.
Bottom of inning number eight set to go. Coming to the plate now, Mark Canna. He went down on strikes last time up. Now the 1-1 pitch. Ah, and he took something off of it there. It's 1-2. Devinsky typically throws a lot of strikes coming in out of the bullpen, resulting in low walk totals, although he has been snake bitten by the home run ball at times in the past.
One of the keys for this guy, Matt, is not being afraid to tag the strike zone. With that said, he is prone to giving up the home runs. I think one of the causes of that, Matty V, he leaves a lot of pitches up in the strike zone. He needs to be down in the zone when he's effective.
Into the corner and slicing foul. 3-2 one more time. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. So that brings up the always intense Matt Chapman. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And he just couldn't keep that ball fair as it winds up a long foul ball. There's ball four. Now at the plate, Chris Davis. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And it's fouled away. Now a fastball taken outside here as it moves it to 2-2 now. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And up next, the outfielder, Stephen Piscotty. Three and one. Hot shot down the line. But this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. The 3-2 pitch is swung on and missed, strike three. Liam Hendricks comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one. Trying to pick things up where we left off. Michael Brantley is coming off a solo homer in his previous trip.
Hey, it's never easy scoring runs against a closer, but this lineup is setting up perfectly right now as the leadoff hitter leads off this inning.
And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
Alec Bregman.
Here's a swing and a little tapper in front of the mound. Throw too late to get him at first. Not a thing of beauty, but it's an infield single nonetheless. Standing in now, Jose Altuve. In the dirt. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And not what they were hoping for as that moves the possible tying run into scoring position. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time. He stays alive, still 2-2. Again, another foul ball. Another try at 2-2. Ball three. 3-2 now. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Digging in, Yordan Alvarez. They'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Not a good spot to be in right now. A pitcher's fallen behind in a count with a guy up that hits really well with runners in scoring position.
Taking called strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight. Last strike now for Houston. Into center field, and that's going to get down for a base hit. Bregman rounds third and is striding for home. He scores, and the Astros have tied it. It's a 4-4 game. Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. In now, Carlos Correa. Two balls and a strike. Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter. This is strike two anyway. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Ready with another two-strike offering. And he strikes him out on a good pitch, so one run can win it as we head to the bottom of the inning. Brad Peacock comes on to work on the mound, hoping to send this one into extra innings.
Number 41.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. Ready now, Austin Allen. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Ramon Laureano. He flew out in his last at-bat. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
Second baseman, Tony.
Even at 1-1, the pitch. Grounder down the line at third. And that's a fair ball as this one gets by him at third. He'll get it into second. The throw pulls him off the bag. Now time is called, and with the potential winning run out there at second, they'll get a little more speed out there to perhaps score on a base hit. Into the box now, Marcus Semien. And this one's in the dirt. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. Runner goes for third. Pitch misses low. The throw down. And it skips in as he steals the bag easily. Ready with the 3-1. And he missed with it there. Ball four. It's a two-out walk with the runner still at third.
How about it?
And that'll bring up Matt Olson as he'll hit with the go-ahead run at third and two away. The 2-1 pitch. On a good pitch there. Had him stretching to get out there. And it's 2-2 now.
Well, he's hoping to be a hero and drive in the winning run.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. We are into extra innings. Into the box now, Miles Straw. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2. A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. Digging in now, Josh Reddick. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. The set and the 1-1 pitch. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike. Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2. Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now. Yuli Gurriel waits on deck. Lifted down the line and left. After it is Davis. And they can't run it down. Payoff pitch one more time. And he lays off. Ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Jake Diekman enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Yuli Gurriel will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. Now the 1-2 pitch. Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2. Diekman is among a dying breed, those lefty specialists. He's able to ride this one high and deep toward right center. But he's going to get there as he runs it down on the warning track for the second out of the inning. Now a at the plate, Martin Maldonado. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. Ready with the 2-1. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now.
Hey, if you're going to get a swing on a pitch that far in off the plate, pretty much options are wide open.
Little chopper back to the mound. Rolando Olson will take care of him at first, and that ends the inning. Ready for the bottom of the 10th here. Digging in, Mark Canha. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. Popped him up. Altuve waits on it. One away. And that'll bring in Matt Chapman.
Third baseman, Matt Chapman.
A 1-1 home. Grounded up the first baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Bounced on the ground and right at the shifted infielders. Altuve has it. Throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close. Settling in now, Chris Davis. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. From the windup, the 2-1 pitch to 2-2 now. A late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. And this is down for extra bases. And there's your winning run moving into scoring position. And this throw gets away from him.
Now batting, the right fielder, Steven.
So now to the plate, Steven Piscotty. Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire. Ball two. This ball will be chopped foul. And he strikes him out to retire the side, so we'll play at least one more. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. Two hits in four attempts to this point. The 1-1 is a fastball that misses. Not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Well, that's ball three, and the Astros right now would do anything to get this leadoff hitter on.
And they'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. Striding in, Alex Bregman, who comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Now the 2-1 pitch. Waves and misses for strike number two.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Full count now, 3-2. And right into the shift. Chapman has it cleanly. And that's the second out. So up to the plate next will be Jose Altuve. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And he strikes him out here for out number three. So after a scoreless top half, they'll have a chance to win it here in the bottom half. Stepping up to the plate, Austin Allen, as he's set to get the bottom of the 11th started. One ball and two strikes to the A's catcher.
That's just too much velocity upstairs to get good wood on it. It's going to have to lower his sights.
Got him. And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
Now batting.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, Ramon Laureano. He went down on strikes last time up. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Reddick has a read on it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Standing in, Jorge Mateo.
Second baseman, Jorge Mateo.
Hung that one out there a bit, but it's a called strike, 2-2. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. Ryan Pressly is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. Stepping in now, Marcus Semien. And did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two. Just behind the fastball there. Two strikes now.
I don't blame the batter for pulling the trigger right there. Those fastballs light up your eyes, and you can occasionally do damage with them. But he wasn't able to catch up with that.
Full count, 3-2. Oh, and this is lined into center field. It's down for a base hit. Long throw to the plate. And they've come back to win it here in 11 innings.
Well, that at bat shows clearer than anything that some guys, they have that clutch gene and some guys just don't. He brings home the winning run from second and is being absolutely mobbed by his teammates. What a finish.
Several good offensive performances in this one, but none better than the one turned in by the guy you see right there. He's our Topps player of the game.
Well, the numbers don't just jump out at you, but his lone hit is a really important one. And sometimes you just need to come through when it matters most to be the hero, and he did just that.
This evening's game comes to an end, 5-4, the final tally. Jake Diekman claims the win out of the pen, his first. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Athletics. 5 runs on 11 hits. No errors. They left 10 men on base. For the Astros, 4 runs on 8 hits. No errors. They left 14 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 12 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.